I got all the later stage plays and the original stage plays. They're all 10.
The past of Fremont New in Baltimore at the Kung Fu Madness House, where he got the best in DVDs on martial arts, you name it, and black exploitation, plays, and so forth. We got Mr. Stewart. The question for you is trying to find out why you think people come in and they're really on this Kung Fu kick. Talk to us about that.
Yeah, I saw some of my latest Kung Fu movies. Most people are getting into it because it's more of like a street vibe, like hip-hop and urban music. They're actually gearing towards it nowadays. So it's like breakdancing is actually coming from the style of martial arts also. So people are throwing a lot of backflips, a lot of windmills and things like that. Actually, people using them in stunts in the movies and things like that. So one of the hottest movies right now is Ambak is also one of the legends out there right now.
How many people do you have coming in out of the store buying Kung Fu movies?
Ideally, it depends. Usually, a good day like today, we have close to maybe 400 people a day out here. Sales are actually real high right now. It's a good market. Kung Fu movies, the latest thing that's on the market right now, especially when you get the latest and the hottest fashions.
Now, the other question for you, most of these people that come in, are they like your average, like, they ain't like a person that studied martial arts. These are like just average, everyday people that just work hard. Describe your average customers that's buying all this stuff.
Kung Fu's been around for so long, and it's like people still believe that this is one of the hottest things out there. It's an urban thing, though. That's the way I see it. And it seems like most people are like focusing on it due to the fact that, It's good martial arts effects to it, sound effects. Also, it's like the average person that comes through here is more like just the general average type person that's actually been doing martial arts for a long time.
Introduction, baby. Tell us about you. Tell us what you're doing down here.
Yeah, well, we're making money, man. We got it all. We got CDs, we got DVDs, we got ringtones. We got what you want. We got everything you need. We got the body flex behind
speed
it.
Speed on and get speed on productions.
You heard him. That's how we're doing it.
People don't, in the urban settings, like so caught up in like martial arts. They ain't in a martial arts school, but they love watching the movies and love the music banging to it. Why that's so?
Fighting. Anything controversial, bro. Anything, men, we like challenges. So anytime it's a challenge involved with it, we want to be a part of it.
Now, hold up. But y'all going to get in trouble because what you're saying, the ladies don't like it either?
Oh, ladies, nah. They get down with it, but they more soap operas. They more suspense.
You know what I'm saying? But see, coming from me and him, experienced boxers, now, you can groove off to anything. It's how you put your mind to it. You know what I'm saying? You can take the beats that you listen to and put them in the movement like, you know what I'm saying?
I am some hip hop legend, aka Ralph Barella, TitaniumGirls.com with a Z, BuffyTheBody.com, CleneyCLENEY.com, ShowShow.com, all online hip-hop.com. That's right, still in effect. What's going on?
Yeah, we got you here on a martial mixtape. I got a question for you. What's the drive between hip-hop music and martial arts? Can you answer that question for me?
Well, hip-hop is a culture, it's a drive with everything, you know. I still say it's rap music and martial arts, you know. But I think that's a whole new effect, you know, something that was brought in by Wu-Tang, you know, with the whole Wu-Tang clan. But now you can put the whole music, the DVD, the videos, everything together. It's a natural blend. You know, especially that joint. I seen the promo on my Hustler. Yo, that's hot.
Where you say that from? Was that a mixtape or something?
It's a mixtape. The DVD great come out, man. Go great, drop some hot joints.
The Marshall Mix, that's what you're talking about?
Marshall Mix. Number one.
You already know they're doing the martial arts thing. Teach everything around the world, holding it down. You already know from DC to LA. You already know I'm actually going back from Africa. 2-week trip, 2-week tour, holding it down out there. Get overseas money now, man. You already know what it is. DJ Rob, Talkers, bro. We out.
This is Sensei Shanks, talking about the old days. So these young guys are just coming up now. We got legends that we opened up. The tournament of the day was held by Sensei Kandi, and he had the Red Shield. That was the name of the tournament. And a lot of these guys that are legends now, we all used to fight back in the brown belt division, in the black belt division. And one of the pioneers, if people don't know, was Willie Bam. He would come out with the Kung Fu. They would stop everything, and they would open up rings. And back in the older days, the karate rings were almost like a 10 by 10 or a 12 by 12. They were not 24, and they were not that big. And Willie would come out and say, could you open this ring? And everybody would stop the whole tournament. He would open up three rings, run run down, do a backflip, come back, backflip, and take the trophies.